Welcome to the Kvasser Linux Driver and SDK Installation Guide. In this video, we will show you how to build and install our Kvasser Linux Driver and SDK. For our demonstration, we'll be using Ubuntu's latest long-term support version of the operating system, 14.04.3. Before we can begin, we'll need to grab the latest version of our Kvasser Linux Driver and SDK. We have provided an annotation in the video so you can click to automatically start the item downloading without having to leave the video. Alternatively, you can visit this URL to download the necessary files. Open a terminal window, then use the change directory command to move to the directory containing the file we just downloaded. Once there, extract the file by typing this command. Now we need to download and make the kernel header files available to the compiler. We can do this by typing this command. Some systems may need to use the command sudo apt-get install linux headers hyphen grave accent uname hyphen r grave accent. Make sure you're using the grave accent and not the single quotation mark. Note, if you do have versions of the Linux header files installed other than that of the currently running kernel, the headers may cause conflicts and faulty drivers. From the LinuxCAN folder, we can now build the drivers and install them. To build the drivers, we're going to type make into the terminal. Once everything's been built, we need to type sudo make install. This will install all of the drivers at once. You can also install specific drivers rather than installing them all at once. However, since all drivers use canlive and the kvcommon driver, you'll need to build and install these first. To install canlive, move to the canlive directory and type make, then type sudo make install, just like we did when we were installing all drivers. Next, move to the kvcommon directory and type make, and then install the kvcommon driver with sudo .install script.sh. Once kvcommon is installed, you can change directory to any driver you want to install and type make to build, and then type sudo .install script.sh to install that driver. Just make sure you've installed canlive and the kvcommon driver first. If you want to build a debug version of the drivers, you can type make kv underscore debug underscore on equals 1, where we would normally use make in the steps we just covered. Now that we've installed our drivers, we want to test to make sure that they've installed properly by using the examples included in canlive. Before beginning, make sure that you have a Kvasser device connected to your computer. For our example, we'll be using a Leaflight V2. Once it's connected, change directory to canlive/examples, type ./listchannels, and if we've installed the drivers correctly, the terminal should list the number of channels available on the bus. USB interfaces like the Leaflight 2 we just used in our test will automatically load and unload the drivers when the devices are inserted or removed from the PC. However, for virtual CAN or interfaces that connect via PCI port, you need to load the drivers manually before use. To do this, type sudo modprobe and then the name of the driver you need to load. For our example, we will load the virtual CAN driver by typing sudo modprobe virtual CAN. If we run list channels again, we can see that the two virtual channels are now listed with the Leaflight V2.